Fallout 4 is a game rated M by the ESRB. Hello and welcome back to more Steven Plays Fallout 4. On the last episode, we came over here to Diamond City. You can see beautiful Diamond City in the background. Looks like the draw distance is a little better than it was on the 360 with some of the other Bethesda games. I can actually see someone kind of in the background walking down some stairs. We explored Diamond City, although we did not finish exploring Diamond City. And I had a ton of comments from you guys telling me things that you would like to see me do, places I need to make sure I don't miss. And one of the things I wanted to do between episodes was listen to Diamond City Radio, because we went and saw Travis, and apparently Grit knew his name, probably because it had assumed that we had listened to the radio. But I recorded a quick clip of Travis actually talking on the radio, so you could actually hear him.
If you're the kind of person who is tired of living in Diamond City, and you maybe want a adventure or something, I guess you have a new option. The settlement of Sanctuary has, I guess, been founded to the northwest there. Good luck to them with, you know, the whole surviving thing. And in other news, it sounds like maybe the... Not other news, it's actually the same news. The Minutemen were involved in this. That's the Minutemen. I thought they were kind of done for. It sounds kind of crazy, if you ask me. And if it were real, it would be super dangerous, I bet.
So that was Travis. And now we know of him, even though we technically already met him. Now, there's quite a bit to do today. On Fallout 4, and there's several people we need to see. There's actually still a good portion of Diamond City to view. But before I do, I want to get up on top of this picnic table and declare something to you. We had a poll to see what was going to be the new length for episodes. Did you guys want 40 minutes, or should we stay at 30? And I'm here to tell you there were thousands of votes, and it was 92.7%. 92% of you wanted longer episodes. And what was interesting is that I checked it shortly after the episode went up, like within, I don't know, just 2 or 3 hours. There was quite a bit of views at that time, but at that point it was 99-1. And that made sense to me, and it was also kind of funny because the people that could watch it like right when it came out were the ones that had, I guess, a little more time, so they cared less that it was 40 minutes. And then as time went on, there were a few other votes that came in to say 30. Now, I want to kind of alleviate some fears here, just for those who had some. People were worried that I was just going to make every single episode, you know, 40 minutes. But I want to clarify something. That's kind of just me getting permission to continue doing things the way I've been doing. I've still been shooting for 30-minute episodes, but there's been a few times where it just didn't feel right to end it at 30. You know, it made more sense to go to 40. And that's what this is about. Apparently there's security over that way. That's what this was important for. So I felt like I had permission to continue doing these 40-minute episodes. So that's what I'm going to continue doing. Started Road to Freedom. Where did I get that? What? Where did I pick that up?
Hey, I think those Bobrov brothers are looking for you.
Talk to the Bobrov brothers. Okay, hold on. If I go back here, summary, if I want to fight the Institute, I've been told I should find the railroad. The only clue I have is follow the Freedom Trail. The tourist trail starts at Boston Common. How did I pick that up? Why do I have so many quests? There's so many quests here. We're still exploring. Anyway, to wrap this up and to not continue to ramble and also walk around, because the more I walk around, apparently I keep getting random quests. Let me just say that we're going to aim for 40 minutes-ish, but if it makes sense to end the episode at, you know, 35, then we will. We won't arbitrarily drag it out. Also, 40 is going to be my hard cap if I can help it. All right, now while I'm standing next to him...
Need a drink. Nuka-Cola.
Well, guess who has a Nuka-Cola for you, buddy?
Here you go.
So gracious of you, sir. I'm sure it's not every day someone shows him such kindness.
Ah, thank you. Thank you.
Sir, if I might bend your ear for a moment...
Hold on, let me talk to this dude.
Hey, Sheffield. What do you think about coming to work for me?
Really? You mean it?
What do you say?
Yeah. Sheffield, go to Sanctuary Hills.
Okay. Maybe this'll be a fresh start.
Well, that was nice. It sounds like I'm on Codsworth's good side, too. Codsworth!
Hey.
Mr. Jones?
Hey, man.
Hey, Codsworth.
Sir, perhaps now would be a good time to speak?
Yeah.
Of course. Go right ahead.
So gracious, sir. I do appreciate it. I've always had such admiration for you and your family, ever since the day my visual senses were first switched on. You and the missus, so good with young Sean, and so trusting of me to look after such a newborn bundle of joy. It just warms my nuclear core. So, you can imagine the distress I felt when the bombs fell, after you fled to the vault. I searched, but found no evidence of your death. I could only hope you all made it in time. And when you returned, I was overjoyed. I admit I ran a full diagnostic scan just to make sure I wasn't malfunctioning. But the news of the missus and Sean, believe me when I say it takes a true hero to live through that.
I'm just doing what it takes to survive out here.
Oh, it's so much more than that, sir. So much more. In such a bleak world as this, think of all you've witnessed and all you've done. In my 200 years, I've seen it tear good men and women apart. But you, sir, you have remained the very model of what humanity should aspire to be.
Thank you, Codsworth. That means a lot.
No thanks necessary, sir. I wouldn't hear of it. I truly believe if the Commonwealth is to turn itself around, you're the one to do it. Now, not another word. I stand firm in my belief. Let's get back to it.
Having reached the highest level of affinity with Codsworth, you have gained the Robot Sympathy perk. We did it. We did it. We reached maximum affinity, and that gives us a perk. And if we go over here to perks... Robot Sympathy. Thanks to your relationship with Codsworth, you receive plus 10 damage resistance against robot energy weapons. So now we can take a little more damage from robots, and we'll be in good shape. Well, thank you, Codsworth, and honestly, I'm going to be quite blunt. That comes at a really good time, because I hate to be like, now we can ditch Codsworth, but now we can ditch Codsworth, and apparently, Piper is someone who can become a companion, and a lot of people think that she should be the next companion, and there's a good chance we'll be talking to her today. But before we do that, there's still other things we need to see. You guys said there's a science center, there's a church, there's a school. We need to see all of these things. So we're going to walk around and find said things. Hello.
Hey there.
Whatever you want, I ain't got time.
I've already learned, the normal residents, man, they just don't care. Wanted, bounties here. What is this place? Well, there's Spaceball. Mo Cronin's house. Schoolhouse! Oh, here's the schoolhouse.
Time for a pop quiz, everyone.
Aww. Mr. Zawicki, we
Maybe
had a pop
a little
quiz
old
yesterday.
To be in school. And we've learned a lot since then, so we're going to reinforce that knowledge with a little quiz.
But I'm tired.
I'm detecting a high degree of fatigue in all our little scholars. Perhaps the quiz can wait?
All right, you guys win. We'll do the quiz later.
Oh,
yes!
Wow. You're tall.
I get that a lot in real life. Hi, how's it going?
Do you know that radiation is why Brahmin have two heads? It's true.
Another traveler. Sorry, you're in the wrong place. This is a school, not a store.
A school, huh?
Yes, every child in Diamond City gets a free education here. We even teach night classes if they have busy day schedules. I'm afraid you're a little old to be enrolling here. Doubt you'd fit in the seats. But it's a public building, so feel free to look around. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to my lesson plans.
Do you need any help with your assignment?
No, I think
I'm fine. A new scholar come to join us. Let's test your math skills. What is 12 times 15? All right, but don't strain yourself. You should always feel free to ask questions.
I'm quite busy with the students, but feel free to look around on your own.
Okay.
If you drink water out in the Commonwealth, you'll get sick. That's what my friend Shang told me.
Hey there, Mr.
Shang's a businessman.
Hi there.
Sometimes we go on field trips to the Science Center. Those are my favorite.
Mr. Everett,
I
want to talk to you,
about your
essay on the history of Diamond City.
I'm really sorry I was late. It's just my cat was sick, and then Everett stole my pencil.
Do all you outside
wanted to say you did a good job. Very clear. Well researched.
Time for a quiz. What is 12 times 15?
My God, there are so many kids talking.
Managing your time. You do great work when you actually finish it.
There's a lot of kids in here to talk to, but they all speak at once.
Well, hello.
Shoot people, sir. My dad says outside of shoot people.
Okay, you don't have subtitles,
Let's
and I can't hear what you're saying.
All of us by our last names. I don't know why. I like my first name better.
How about you, Phil?
Well, hello.
Only subject I like is geography. You get to look at maps and stuff. 16. That's easy.
But what if
they're teaching school in here?
I should study.
You say anything, Nina?
Hey, sweetie.
Hi.
Okay, we're done in here. This is interesting, and it's cool to look at, but there's too many characters all trying to speak at one time.
I ain't scared of them.
Can I go in here?
No, really.
Well, hello, kitty cat. You're a cutie. You're a cutie. I wish there was a pet command. Did you know that I put pictures of you and your people on every single settlement?
I wouldn't do that.
Did you know that? that security guard thought I was taking a crap in here. Alright, this is fun, but I think what I'm going to do before I get too much further into this is actually go try and find Piper and switch her out. I don't know if I can even do that immediately, but switch her out so we can work towards getting her perk instead of Codsworth's. Now, from what I understand from you guys and then also from the context of the game, she was really mad at the mayor, so I need to figure out where the mayor is, and I presume that the mayor would be up in the quote-unquote stands, so I guess we're just going to go this way until we can figure that out. Do you happen to know where your sister is?
Next issue, just you wait.
Nat.
Public is here to pull the wool out from under your eyes.
Alright, thanks, Nat. Oh, that's convenient. Mayor this way. Got stuck on a step. Walking is hard, said Grit Jones. Mayor. And there's an elevator? Well, that's fancy. The elevator's already... Oh, this is the elevator. Oh, Codsworth, I'm sorry. Oh, Codsworth. Codsworth. Codsworth, I'm sorry. He's down there stuck in a bush. You know what, buddy? Maybe it was time that you headed back to Sanctuary. I think maybe you need to take a break from adventuring if you're stuck in bushes. Now the question is, am I going to find Piper here? Or does she have... Well, oh, she might have been down at her office. That's true. Oh, crap. Hello?
Mayor's in no mood to talk about any of this synth nonsense. Unless you're looking for a housing permit, I can't help you.
Wait. What was that about synths?
Oh, no. I'm not saying anything. I like my job, thank you very much.
And you are?
Geneva, the mayor's secretary. I handle all the day-to-day.
And this was the girl that, the hairdresser's mother is, like, obsessed is a synth.
I'm looking for work.
Mercenary type? We usually have a few open bounties. Just check the wanted posters in the market.
Check out the wanted poster.
Well, let's hear about the permit.
We have one home available. It's in the center of town, right near the market. You can do whatever you like with the interior, and all the tools you need to make your own furnishings are provided at no extra charge.
Tell me more about this house.
The previous owner bought an adjacent warehouse and knocked down a few walls, so it's bigger than most. And he left behind his old tools, so you'll have everything you need to modify the inside however you see fit.
Let me think it over.
Take all the time you need.
So I can't go see the mayor right now?
No funny business around the mayor. Got it?
Mayor?
I'd love to talk, but I have matters to attend to.
Okay.
McDonough?
Far too busy to talk right now. I'm the mayor.
I have to overlook things from this window. Okay, well, one thing I could probably do, I didn't really think about it until right the second, I think one of my quests is, Story of the Century. Of course Piper is in her office, dear God. Let's jump ahead to that. I'm so sorry, buddy. You're really getting the short end of the stick today. All right, so down here at public occurrences is a door. That's where I need to go. Okay, talk to Piper. Oh, there you are.
Glad you dropped by. You holding up, Blue?
Why are you calling me that?
Because you're a vault dweller? I know you're not wearing the blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish-out-of-water look... dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you get used to the world above ground.
Hmm.
What kind of interview is this gonna be?
I ask you who you are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My options are pretty fantastic.
It was just me and 1,000 guinea pigs. They turned carnivorous.
Okay, I guess we're gonna have to go with the satirical approach to this article. So, you've seen the Commonwealth. Diamond City, how does it compare to your old life?
Can you even compare the two? The world out here? It's not even close to the one I left.
Feeling a little homesick, are we? Can't say I blame you. Now, the big question. You came all this way looking for someone. Who is it?
I lost family, okay? I'm trying to get one of them back.
What's their name, Blue? Who are they?
My son, Sean, was kidnapped. He's not even a year old.
The parent after the missing child. As heartbreaking today as it ever was. Tell me, do you suspect the Institute's involved?
I don't know.
No one ever does. That's what makes them so scary. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
Wait, people just ignore kidnappings out here?
Yeah, Blue, you haven't noticed? You grow up in the Commonwealth and eventually someone is gonna get taken. Maybe not someone you know, but someone. And people just say, well, could have been worse. Could have been killed by raider attacks, or super mutants, or feral ghouls. They just give up. So I want my readers to hear what keeps you going. Maybe they'll find a little inspiration. Now what would you like to say?
No matter how much you want to give up, don't. You have to have hope that you'll see them again. Or at least, that you'll know the truth.
A strong note to end on, Blue. Thanks. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back? Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where this story goes next.
I'm gonna be honest, I actually can't believe that that was as easy as it was. Like, you just, pretty much, as soon as you get into town and you meet her, you just walk in and you're like, hey, come with me? And she's like, yeah, okay, sounds good.
Let me know if there's anything I can do to lighten the load, or, you know, if you need anything proofread.
Hey, Piper.
Heading my way?
Sure, let's go.
Will do.
Send Codsworth back to Sanctuary. I think Codsworth was not even in here, so I don't even say goodbye to him. That's kind of sad.
Hey.
What you got for me?
Piper.
Something to say?
Your thoughts?
Never thought a reporter could consider themselves a success until someone threatened their life. Me? I'm very successful.
Hmm.
Are things all right between us?
Well, things aren't bad. Because believe me, you'd know if they were. But I suppose we could be doing better.
That's all.
Sure.
Okay, so here we are in this place. We've left Codsworth. We got max affinity with him. Piper is now with us and apparently really likes to chill. It doesn't count as stealing as we walk around and look at things in this place. Toy car. Guess we can take the toy car.
Better shape than I expected.
It's got... I mean, it has screws in it, so we can use that. Radaway? Yeah, you're not using any of this, right? So I could just raid all of your stuff? What's upstairs? Bobby pin box? Piper's terminal. This could be an interesting, interesting read. Let's see, your eyes on the truth. So this is the article that was... Yeah, this is the article that we got when we first came in to... Diamond City. We don't need to... It's a really long article. Okay. Read your complaints file. Honor the wall. Date 215. In your most recent edition, your paper failed to acknowledge in any way the contribution of the mighty wall in the defense of our town against last month's super mutant attacks. I find this extremely offensive and will not be purchasing another copy until such disrespect is publicly corrected. Published response. We honor the efforts of all those involved in the defense of our great city, from our valiant guards to the mighty wall. Personal response. Dear Whackjob, two members of Diamond City Security died defending this town. Where was your hunk of plywood for them? And happy story. I find choice of topic sad. How about happy story? Maybe something about nice bar. I wonder who wrote that. Thank you for your feedback. Our stories are selected for relevance and importance to the Diamond City populace. Personal response. Vadim, no story about your bar is going to end happily. Read a complaint for shame. Your paper is just trying to drum up fears about synths to increase sales. You should be ashamed of yourself. Publish response. Thank you for your concern. Our paper makes significant efforts to ensure all our stories are accurate and free from editorializing. Personal response. Thank you for your concern. I hope you get snatched. And then finally, Public Perspectives Archive. Let's see. Dear Public... I'm torn between two loves. On one hand, I have my profession. Every moment I spend with the young up-and-comers for whom I work with whom I work brings such joy. On the other hand, I have my coworker, wise, patient, debonair. Many suggest I am not lively enough for him, but I can picture life with no other. I long to confess my feelings for him, but my life is my work. Trying to add a relationship, it would simply shortchange everyone. I must choose Public, but who? Love is rare. Two, doubly so. Make it work, pair. Your work. You work in the same building for shuck's sakes. Teen Troubles. Dear Public, me and my little girl have been on our own for a long time now. She's the most important thing in my life, but lately, it seems like she's not as interested in hanging out with her papa. I understand she's gotta grow up someday, but I'm not ready to let her go. What do I do to make sure I don't lose my little girl? From Teen Troubles. Dear Troubles, your girl's becoming her own person. Let her make decisions, screw up. Maybe throw some extra caps her way so she can take her friends out for noodles more often. Then, when she's ready, she'll come to you. Desperate in Diamond City. Dear Public, I've been living in Diamond City for years now, but have never been able to land a girlfriend. I wear nice clothes and give them free drinks, but they just seem to think I'm some sort of creep. My boss says I've got a face only a mother could love, and I think he's right. I feel like I'm out of options, Public. Should I take the plunge and change my face? Desperate in Diamond City. Dear Desperate, ever tried talking to these girls? You should give it a go. No more trying to buy your way to affection. You need to earn it. Sleepwalking the beat. Dear Public, I got this job. It pays the bills, but lately it's making it so I can't sleep at night. Things have been so tense. I'm getting worried that if something doesn't change, I might slip up and get myself or someone else hurt. Any advice, Public? Sleepwalking the beat. Dear Beat, sounds like you need to relax more. I know after a hard day solving other people's problems, I like to grab a Nuka-Cola, pull out a stack of comics, and read till I pass out. Give it a try. And Alone in the Upper Stands. Dear Public, I could... Oh, I thought it was giving me a quest thing. It's like, you leveled up. I could use a friend. Everyone in this town is either jealous of me or afraid of me because of how I look and who I work for. I'm not willing to compromise who I am just so people will like me more, but it just gets so lonely. But you seem like a smart gal, Public. Any chance you want to grab a drink sometime? Alone in the upper stands. Dear Alone, going to have to take a rain check on that drink, but your instincts are good. New friends crop up in the most unlikely places. You just need to search them out. All right. So, we got some information there. It's just fun to learn about these characters, to be honest. Bobby Pin, greaser jacket and jeans. Damage resist. Well, of course, everything's better than what I have on right now. Because I'm wearing a suit. Purified water. Some shotgun shells. Yeah, I'll take that. There's a door that leads to Diamond City up here, which is curious. Might take that before I head out. Let's see if there's anything else down here. Rat poison. I don't know why I keep taking rat poison. I just feel compelled for some reason. Take this stuff. This. Gas canister. The hot plate. I'm carrying too much? Since I got into Diamond City? Hey, Piper.
Hey.
Shoot.
Yeah, I'm... You don't? Okay, great, because you're actually going to be my junk mobile. If you could carry all of this, that'd be fantastic, thanks. Got over and covered a lot faster than I normally do, and I think it's because I'm carrying the godforsaken, the fat boy and the missile launcher. I think those combined are not helping. Let's head out this door and see where it goes. And this comes out
loud. Full of corrupt officials and brown-nosing citizens, but it's home.
There's a really weird error. There's a big graphical error, but it corrected itself, so that's good. Where's this go? It's fine. Just drop down. All right, now we still have to check out the Science Center and also the church, All Faiths Chapel. Okay. There's some folks in here.
I don't know if this praying thing works. But it couldn't hurt.
If you're here to pray, sit down and be quiet.
Okay.
Good to see someone new in the chapel. Diamond City treating you all right?
This your chapel here, Pastor?
Well, that depends. I suppose I should say this chapel really belongs to God. But since I never get around to deciding which God in particular, I guess you could say it belongs to all of them. Now, if you ever need a quiet place to sit down and ponder the Almighty in whatever form strikes your fancy, we're always open.
So, you don't practice any particular religion here?
As long as you believe in something, you're welcome. Diamond City is full of people trying to build a better life. I just don't want them to forget what makes them human while they're at it. So, the chapel is open 24 hours a day. To whatever form of worship you like, long as it's peaceful.
I'm just gonna take a look around.
Go right ahead.
It's pretty much the, well, it's called the All Faiths Chapel, and that makes sense. It's all faiths. Is there anything in here of note? Not particularly.
I did.
I'm also pretty sure I don't think I can pray. I think really the only thing I can do is sit. Oh, interesting. You feel a sense of quiet reflection. Oh, so something did happen. But what? Is that actually a stat change of some sort? No. Weird. Okay. Interesting. You have anything more?
Pastor.
Go ahead and sit anywhere you like.
Okay. That was odd. You're a sitter, man. You really like to sit. All right, Piper, let's go. We gotta find the Science Center. Okay. Now, I'm not really sure where the Science Center is, but I figure if we look around, we'll find it. Maybe some other things, too. Choice.
We just had some meat. That's it.
The heck is this thing? Who knows? Okay, dugout in. We do need to go back there at some point because we're supposed to go see the Bobrov brothers again.
I'm telling you how to pick your friends. The pipe is kind of a troublemaker.
You know, you just said that in front of Piper, right? Dr. Soon's house. Let's see, we've been over this way before.
Whatever you want, I ain't got time.
Okay, I'm not exactly sure where this place is. But there's also something over here. Oh wait, this is nothing. This is just a Big Doc. Okay. Before I forget, I think I'm actually going to I think I'm actually going to use my level up. And there's a few different things I could go for, but I think I'm going to go ahead and grab expert level terminals just so I have it, because I think it's important to have. And then once we get to level 21, we can get master terminals. But at least that's done, and we have that, so I don't have to think about it too much. There's other things we can do, but we'll come back to them. Valentine Detective Agency. Is this... Oh, I know what this is. Because we have a thing for this. Go to Valentine's Detective... Okay, that's the start of another big quest, so maybe we should actually avoid that for right this second.
Don't let down the home team by a swatter!
That guy is still pushing that. Alright, I'm gonna find the Science Center.
Got chems right here for you, brother.
Oh. Okay, this is a little different. Hi, buddy.
Did you say something about drugs?
That's right. All the chems you need to fill out your lifestyle. Balance you out. Everyone here buys from me. Sometimes security needs a little psycho, or an engineer needs some Mentats. And heck, Rad X is plain universal.
Looking for a job, if you got one.
Yeah, I got something. Looking for a mutated fern, if you find any. I hear some grows out near Forest Grove Marsh. Natural radiation sucker. Be great for cooking Rad X or Rad Away.
Hmm.
Sweeten the deal with some money, and I might be interested.
All right. How about 125 caps?
Come on. Make it worth my while, Solomon.
You are one righteous talker. 150 caps.
Even more money. It's Red. How good is your charisma, Grit Jones?
I'll walk out right now, if you don't make me a real offer.
200. That's all I can pay. I swear.
Mutated fern. Sounds good.
Cool.
Lou, can I get a minute? Something I need.
So Piper... Piper's very different from Codsworth. By the way, this is where I'm at. This is the health center. So of course the drug guy is right next to it. Codsworth didn't... In fact, it said Codsworth disliked that. Which is weird, because Codsworth's supposed to be its sanctuary. Really confused. So, Codsworth didn't like it whenever I asked for more money. But Piper does. Piper's like, yeah, that's cool.
Tell me, are you worried about the possible infiltration of Diamond City's ruling elite by suits?
Yeah, Piper, I am. But I ain't buying your lousy newspaper.
Ooh.
Oh, well, thanks, I guess.
Come on, Piper, it's raining and we still have to find the Science Center. So I finally found the Science Center. A lot of the doors are very inconspicuous, there's not a lot of signs. Over here is where Diamond City Radio and Sheng was, and then right up here, this tiny little door, I guess they have this little sign out front, but it's very hard to tell, is the Science Center.
Professor, I have a new theory about how the Institute makes the synths.
Oh no, we've been talking about this, remember? After last time. Shouting, me sleeping on the cold floor of the lab for 3 nights.
That was your choice.
And seriously, growing synths from the ground using recombinant plant nuclei? I mean, how could they even... Aha! You do want to talk about it. Oh, look, we have a visitor. Dr. Duff, dear. If you could bother them while I walk away from this conversation.
Hi there. Are you here for today's free biology lesson?
Biology lesson?
That's right. Usually the kids from the schoolhouse are the first to drop by, but I don't see why I can't start the lesson with you. Now, we all talk about radiation like it's a single thing, but it's actually a term referring to dozens of different ionizing rays. You have X-rays, beta rays, gamma rays, but which one are we most worried about? The one most associated with the big old bombs 200 years ago?
Who gives a crap rays?
No, not quite what we're looking for. The answer is gamma rays. Now, gamma rays are bad. Really bad. If your body absorbs too much of that kind of radiation, you'll suffer from fatigue, anemia, even death. But some life forms have been living with gamma radiation exposure for 2 centuries now, and they've adapted. Neat, huh?
What kinds of things have adapted to radiation?
Oh, that's the perfect segue into the field trip portion of the lesson. Are you ready?
Field trip?
That's right. You go out, do some science of your own, and come back. I usually have a prize for the best junior scientist, which I guess is just automatically going to you. What do you say?
Sign me up.
You're gonna go out and find a bloatfly gland. You see, the oversized bloatfly of today evolved from an earlier species of a smaller fly. Radioactive adaptation has resulted in a unique gland that enables it to balance and maintain speed despite its size. So what do you say? Ready to go out and dissect one?
I do a job. I get paid.
Money? Oh. How about, 125 caps?
Apparently Piper disliked that. So, interesting. So asking the biology teacher was a little crummy, but asking the drug guy for money was apparently okay. Alright, I'll take 125 so I'm not making her upset.
Just the right words. That's what I do.
Get the blowfly gland. Got it.
Remember, bring the gland back in one piece. Oh, and don't chew on it. One of the students got horribly sick because of that mistake.
Apparently when you take quests, Piper likes that. Oh. Well, that's interesting. That's a little different. So now we have another thing to do. See, it's funny. I usually have bloatfly glands on me, but I guess I don't have one now. That's something that I'll have to try and accomplish. Anything else of interest around here? There's workbenches, makeshift batteries.
Dissecting a bloatfly can be fun. Just avoid getting stung to death, and you'll be a junior scientist in no time.
Where's your friend?
Professor Scara.
Dr. Duff handles all the visitors. Bother her.
Oh, okay. Well, folks, I think we're actually going to wrap it up here. I am thoroughly impressed by how many quests are available in Diamond City and how much there is to see and do. I mean, we've now spent two 40-minute episodes walking around. We haven't seen anything. There are places we have not gone into. That's crazy. Diamond City is gigantic. But now I come to you guys. What is it you want to do next time? Now, we can continue to explore Diamond City, and certainly there's more to see, but I'm thinking that maybe we'll take a slight detour. Instead of working on doing more stuff in Diamond City, maybe we'll do one of the many quests that we've picked up while we've been here. We have Road to Freedom, which I think is probably... It's not exactly what I had in mind. I was thinking something like this, because Mo wants us to do that, or Painting the Town. Maybe both of those. I'm thinking maybe do those and then come back, so we can take like an episode out of the city and then maybe come back to it and work on some of the other stuff. We have quite a lot of quests, and one of the things I really want to keep different from, I could turn that off. One of the things I really want to keep different from Skyrim is I don't want all these quests to always be lingering around. I would really like to take care of them, so we don't always have a bunch. One of the problems, I think, one of the negatives for Skyrim was the fact that we ended up getting so many quests, and sometimes it would take forever before we ever got back to it, and by that time you would forget why we were doing it in the first place. I would like to avoid that. So if we can get rid of some of these quests before we get new ones, that would be fantastic. So with that in mind, you guys know what the quest list is like. Tell me what you want to see next time. I thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the new 40-minute format, even though we've been doing a few at 40 minutes. And see you guys next time for more Steven Plays Fallout 4.